Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. So in this video we'll have a look at how does a crypto wallet works. It's imperative that you watch until the end because there have been some significant developments with regards to how wallets works and how they interact with one another. The best way to understand how a crypto wallet works is to look at your traditional wallet. Your traditional wallet holds a bank card, an ID card, driver's license, fiat currencies, and most importantly, it can hold multiple fiat currencies at the same time. Crypto wallet, on the other hand, holds digital assets such as cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, Ethereum, and other altcoins. Fiat currencies in the form of stable coins like Tether, collectibles such as NFTs. This can include music, artwork, land ownership, and more. I'm sure you'll agree that these wallets are very similar, but one thing that sets them apart is that one is a physical wallet, meaning you can physically touch it and interact with it. The other is a digital wallet, meaning you can only interact with it via web interface. It's also worth noting that there are cryptocurrency wallets that are physical wallets, meaning these are physical hardware devices and paper wallets. But obviously to use them, you have to connect your hardware device to the internet or use something called SEED, which is a 12-bit encrypted recovery key. If you want to find out how to set up your crypto wallet correctly, I have a dedicated playlist, which I'm going to link at the end of this video. So keep watching. Okay, let's look at how it works. Sending or receiving digital assets is similar to sending an email. So if you ever sent an email in your life, you'll be able to use a Bitcoin wallet. To send an email, you need a mailing app, a recipient's email address, then type your email. For example, you can say, "Dear people of the tube, if you find any value in these videos, please smash the like button and press send." With crypto assets such as cryptocurrencies, on the other hand, you must first choose a specific cryptocurrency, then select the network. The receiving wallet must support the same network that you're sending from, or your funds will be lost forever. For example, if you're sending the ERC20 cryptocurrency, you must be using the Ethereum network. Sometimes the same ERC20 cryptocurrency can be supported by other blockchains, such as the Binance Smart Chain. It's also worth noting that there are many blockchain networks out there. Some interact with one another, some do not, but we'll cover that in future videos. Depending on the blockchain or the network and how congested the network is, the funds can reflect on the recipient's wallet in just few minutes. For example, this transaction took just less than 2 minutes to reflect on the other wallet. Okay, now let's look at how these transactions are executed. Again, to better understand this, let's look at how an email works. An email is sent from your device to the intended recipient. However, before it gets to the recipient, it first goes to the database and gets stored there. The database then makes a copy of the email, then forwards that to the recipient. With cryptocurrencies, a user sends a specific cryptocurrency from their wallet. The transaction is broadcasted to the network, which is a group of computers or nodes, also known as miners, which verifies these transactions. Once verified and confirmed, the specific cryptocurrency will reflect on the user's wallet. If you have any difficulties with understanding how this process works, make sure you check out my video where I go in-depth with regards to how does a blockchain technology works. For more in-depth tutorials on every topic we mentioned in this video, such as NFTs, blockchain, smart chain, and stable coins, please check out the rest of the channel and also consider subscribing. As always, if you have any questions, leave them on the comment section below and I'll be there to answer them. Showing up on the screen right now should be the playlist that will help you get started with regards to setting up your own cryptocurrency wallet. That's it from me. I'll see you on the next one. Goodbye for now.